Hello everyone, good morning. I hope all of you are good and I am also fine. So the first question from the graph related topics. The question is like that: a body starts from rest at t equal to 0. The acceleration time graph is shown in the figure. This is the acceleration time graph. The maximum velocity attained by the body will be what? We have to find out. Four options is given. Okay, so let's try. So all of you remember the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, I already discussed how can we find the velocity from acceleration time graph. Okay. So what is given here? This is on the graph. We know that velocity is equal to area under the graph, is not it? Is area under the graph. Okay, so which area is there? This is the area, is not it? This is the graph. Suppose this one is A, this one is B. This is the area under the graph. Okay, so this area, this mass of area, we have to find out, and it will represent the velocity. It will give the velocity of the system. Okay, so that is half into base. Base means UV, and height is UA. Okay, right? That is half into base. Base is what? 11, and height is 10. This it will be 5, and it will be 55 meter per second. So option velocity B equal to what, sir? 50 meter per second. So option B will be correct. Option B will be correct answer. Okay. I hope all of you understood this one. It's so simple. Take a screenshot from that one. Just multiply. Simple multiplication is there. This one is acceleration time graph, and acceleration time graph, we can find the area under the graph, and this area under the graph will give you the velocity. The velocity is area means this one is one triangle figure. So in case of writing a triangle, how can I find the area of the triangle? There is half into base into height. Base is 11 and height is 10. The 2 into 10 and it will be 5, and if I multiply 11 into 5, it will be 55 meter per second. Okay, so hello everyone. So another question from graph related questions. The displacement time graph of two moving particles makes angle 30 degree and 45 degree with the time axis. Okay, the ratio of the velocity. So we have to find out the velocity is was four option is given here. So let's try. So here, look. We know that from a distance time graph, the velocity is what? Slope. The velocity is slope. Okay, slope will be gives the velocity of the graph. So now velocity of first particle is BA equal to how much? 1030, is not it? 1030 degree, that is 1/√3. Again, velocity of second body is BB equal to 1060 degree. Okay, so therefore ratios of velocities is what? BA is to BB, that is 1/√3 is to root 3, that is 1/√3 into root 3 into root 3 into root 3. So it will become 1:3. So which option is correct? 1:3. So the correct answer is what? The correct answer is here 1:3. Option C is correct. So option C is the correct answer. Okay. So it's so simple. I just take the velocity of A will be BA equal to 1030 degree. That is 1/√3. And velocity of B will be 1060 degree. That is root 3. Just divide this one. BA is to BB. That is 1/√3 is to 1/√3. Then after simply what becomes? 1:3. Okay. So this is the correct answer. So take a screenshot from that. I hope it is helpful for you. Hello everyone. So another question from graph. So the question is like that: what will be the ratio of speed in first 2 seconds to the speed in next 4 seconds? Okay, this is the graph. We have to find out the speed in different cases. So speed in first 2 seconds is b1 equal to, this one is displacement time graph. This one is distance and this one is time, is not it? This one is time and this one is distance. So from the distance time graph, we can find distance by time is speed, is not it? Distance is s zero and time is two. Again, speed in second next 4 seconds is v two equal to, that is this, for this triangle, this one is the displacement and this one is time, and for this, for next two, that is after 2 1 2 3 4 6, okay, so this one will be the time and this will be the distance. So distance will be same as 0 and time will be 6 minus 2, it will be as 0 by 4. So therefore we can write b1 is to b2 equal to what, as 0 by 2 is to as 0 by 4, as 0 is to cancel out, that is 1 by 2 into 1 by 4. Come here, so b1 is to b2 equal to 1 by 2 by 1 by 4, that will be 1 by 2 into 4 by 1, that is 2, it is 2 by 1. So what will be the ratio? 2 is to 1. The 2 is to 1 is the correct answer, okay. 2 is to 1 is the correct answer. Option C is correct. So let me explain again in 10 seconds. We have to find out the ratio for the first 2 seconds and for the next 4 seconds. So in the first 2 seconds, this one is the distance and this one is time. So velocity is what? B1 equal to distance by time. And for the next 4 seconds, this one is the distance and this one is the time. So this will be s 0 by 6 minus 2, that is s 0 by 4. And after that, I just find out the ratio is what? It becomes 2 is to 1. Okay? So I hope this is helpful for you. So thank you. Hi everyone. So another question from distance time graph. And the question is like that. Which of the following distance time graph shows accelerated motion? Which of the following distance show accelerated motions? Okay. So look at it. There are different. This one is uniform velocity. It will be not. Okay. And this one is rest. This one is rest. This is different. Rest. This is uniform. Speed. Is not it? Okay, this also not. So which option is correct? Option A is correct here. Why? Because the distance time graph shows accelerated motion always is parabola shape. Okay, it will always in parabolic with distance as its axis or about distance axis. Okay, and we can prove this. So always remember that one, the distance time graph will show accelerated motion is always in parabola shape, and its axis parabola axis of the parabola will be in the of the distance axis will be the parabola of the axis. Okay, so thank you for watching. I hope this is helpful for you a lot. Thank you.